All right, welcome back everybody, while we uncover part two in discovering the true meaning of Bootstrap. Stick with me, it's gonna be interesting. So when I say the true meaning of Bootstrap, the server case itself is not bootstrapped. But there's gonna be some janky things, there's gonna be some interesting parts. We are gonna use some used parts because we're trying to keep this as Bootstrap and as cheap as possible. So, as we get going, I am going to take the lid off of this guy. You get to build a server with me today. I know you've probably watched other cool hip people make servers, but probably not one as janky as this. The one thing that we did spare no expense on, and kind of keeping in the theme of the video, a Rosewill power supply. You know, there's a lot of debate on good power supplies, making sure that things don't blow up, making sure that everything works really, really effectively. I wanted to make sure that the power supply had enough power cables and fit the case and everything kind of matches. This one is fairly unique in that it has a lot of SATA power connectors. As with most things at current year and date and time, there is a lot of shipping shortages. So a lot of our stuff took way longer to get to us than we ever thought it would. Every part of it past this point is really Bootstrap. Even our hard drives, we were able to source for, you know, $15 a piece for 4 gig or 4 terabyte hard drives. Like we have scrounged around. The other thing that we did buy on the low end was the CPU. So I will say that this thing's a little bit sharp on the metal. I haven't cut myself on this type of metal in a while, but I will say after the fact, after getting a bunch of micro cuts on my fingers, you should be a little bit leery of that, A lot of the other parts we did buy secondhand, like I was saying. We did buy an 8120. We also did get a bunch of spare parts as well, which we'll clean. If you hadn't noticed, there is a lot of hand sanitizer around, and sometimes rubbing alcohol is hard to get as well. If you think that this is absolutely the wrong way to clean a CPU, heatsink, and fan, you are probably right. And actually, I might even let this just sit on here and soak a little bit, because that is thick. And this didn't even come with the CPU. We ordered the CPU. I think that one came from Ohio. And even then, I don't even know what the final price of everything is going to be, just because we're actually gonna sell stuff. Like I have an extra power supply, I'm probably gonna sell it. And so the final price of everything, I'm really hoping to be under 400. Excluding the hard drives, you know, that's gonna bump us up closer to like 600. But we're gonna get as close and as cheap as possible. Now this is, if I remember right, this is an MSI board, yeah. The main reason I picked it up was because it has so many SATA ports. And so it was easier for us to get a board that had as many SATA as possible, as cheap as possible, and then do at least one add-on board. Now, the main thing that we should probably do is to do a test boot, make sure the stuff that we do have does actually work first and foremost. The other thing too is I haven't even inspected the CPU. Like it arrived in the mail yesterday and I brought it into the office. Okay, so I'm gonna call this even. Like we'll probably clean it one more time before we actually like install everything together. But I do wanna check on the CPU. Like I said, I haven't even opened this. I don't even know if it has bent pins or what the status is. You know, we trust people on eBay. So we'll see, hopefully person from Cleveland is helpful and delightful. Actually, that looks really, really good. I don't know what the videographer is doing about doing zooms and stuff, but this actually looks really, really solid. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and drop that in. Perfect. So we're using Cooler Master. Thanks guys. High performance thermal compound kit. My local store had it. Yeah, that's about right. Yeah, this latching mechanism could be a lot better.
or I just need to figure out what to do with my life.
All right. Yeah, that's pretty snug, right? You can pick it up, throw it, should be fine. And once again, this is a little bit older of a motherboard. There is no HDMI, there is no DisplayPort. We don't need that junk. This is a server, guys, come on. We don't need all that fancy 4K stuff. We just need it to turn on. Yeah, I need to reach over, have this stretch, have this plug in, flip a switch, and then figure out where that jumper is. This is a bad motherboard. This is a horrible video. And we'll have to make a part 3. We know that we're not grounded anywhere. We know that nothing is damaged. The CPU fan is properly plugged in. Power is here, it's good. I'm gonna just reseat it just to make sure I'm not crazy. And no fan spin. All right, well, this was a great part 2. We are gonna feature this more if we get a working motherboard, and we'll let you know. Thanks so much for attending our janky server video editing guide.